Hi students, today in this video we go for the revision of question 2A and it is poetry comprehension, that read the poem and answer the question. One or two stanzas of the poem given to you and you have to read that those stanzas and you have to attempt the questions given in the paper. So let's start the revision. And here is the stanza of poem 1. The ant and the cricket. A silly young cricket, accustomed to sing through the warm sunny months of gay summer and spring, began to complain when he found that at home his cupboard was empty and winter was come. Not a crumb to be found on the snow-covered ground, not a flower could he see, not a leaf on a tree. Oh, what will become, says the cricket, of me? Here the poet says that a silly means a foolish young cricket, accustomed means used to sing, and he sing all the time that through the warm sunny months and gay summer and spring. Gay means cheering, and begin to complain when he found that at home his cupboard was empty. He not stored anything, not stores anything for him, and winter was come and no, not a crumb to be found. Crumb means bread, a piece of bread on the snow-covered ground. Not a flower could he see. Now at the winter time he could not see the flower and the leaf on a tree, and now he became worried and sighed that, oh, what will become of me in this winter time. So this is the first stanza of the poem, and now we go for the questions from this stanza. And here is the first question, that why does the poet call the cricket foolish? Here the word silly means foolish. Answer: because he is short-sighted. Short-sighted means he was not thinking about his future, and he sang all the time. So poet says him short-sighted. And now we go for the second. And here is the second, that what did the cricket do all summer months? Means what did he do the activity? Answer: the cricket sang all summer months. He only sang and sang all summer months, and he did not store any food for him for the winter. Number three is, what does the phrase accustomed to mean in this stanza? Answer: accustomed to means used to. Used to means habitual. So these three questions from the poem 1's stanza, and now we go for poem number 2, geography lesson. And here is the poem number 2, geography lesson, and it is the first stanza of the poem. When the jets sprang into the sky, it was clear why the city had developed the way it had. Seeing it scaled 6 inches to the mile, there seemed an inevitability about what on ground had looked haphazard, unplanned and without style when the jet sprang into the sky. Here the poet observed the city from the aeroplane. The jet is the name of a plane. Sprang means moved, went up. When the jet aeroplane went up in the sky, the poets looked at the city, that the way it developed. Seeing it scaled 6 inches to the mile, there seemed an inevitability means we can't avoid. The city had spread about what on ground had looked haphazard means without proper order and unplanned. The city was very unplanned and without style. There is no any style of the city that it had developed when the jet sprang into the sky. When the jet move up in the sky, the poet describes that the city is very unplanned, and we can't avoid the way that it had spread. So this is the first stanza of the poem, and now we go for the questions from this stanza. And here is question number 1, that what does the poet describe here? What does, which thing the poet describe here? Answer: the poet describes the scene of a city here. The poet describes the scene of the city here, that how the city looked from the jet plane. And now we go for the second. And number two is, what does the poet notice? Answer, the poet noticed that the city is not planned. It is very unplanned. And number three, what does the line "there seemed an inevitability" mean? Answer, "there seemed an inevitability" means we can't avoid the way the city had spread. Means we can't stop that the city had spread, the city had developed. So these are three question answers from the poem 2. And now we go for poem number 3. And here is the poem number 3, that Macavity the Mystery Cat. Macavity, there is no one like Macavity. He is broken. Every human law, he breaks the law of gravity. His powers of levitation would make a fakir stare. And when you reach the scene of crime, Macavity is not there. You may seek him in the basement, you may look up in the air, but I tell you once and once again, Macavity is not there. So this is the stanza of the supernatural powers of Macavity, that we can't see Macavity at the place of crime. And levitation means he can float in the air, and he broke every human law, and he breaks law of gravity, means law of nature also. And we can't seek him in the basement or in the air also. So this is the power of Macavity, that we can't find him at the place of crime. And now we go for the questions from this stanza. And here are the questions, that number one, who is Macavity? Answer, Macavity is a master criminal in the shape of a cat. He is a master criminal, that he broke every human law and law of nature. Number two, how is he a master criminal? Means how we see that he is a master criminal? Answer, he has broken all the laws of human as well as nature. So he is a master criminal. And now we go for the third. And here is the third question, that how does he break Newton's law of gravity? Answer, he floats in the air without support, so he break Newton's law of gravity. Number four, what is the main feature of Macavity? That answer is, it is difficult to trace him out, means we cannot find him. This is the main feature of Macavity. And number five is, what does the word levitation in the above stanza mean? Here we have to write the meaning of word levitation, and the answer is floating in the air. So these five question answers from poem number 3. You have to repeat all the question answers, and you have to read the stanzas of the poems very, very well. Thank you.